Hello, everybody. This is your officer, Commander Coldburn, back with you with episode 18 of Let's Play Alundra. Last episode, we slayed Reptilicus Maximus, got our second crest, and saved the game. I had to do a little playback after the boss just to see if the video was palatable. And I'm waiting on feedback from my, inspection agent on the video to see whether it needs to be redone. And if it does, I have to start my whole, file over again. So let's hope my agent, says it is okay. So, anyway guys, now that we're done in there, let's talk to, some of the villagers, see what's going on in town. And I just got smacked by a slime. How dare you? Alrighty. Stupid bee. If only there were piggies I could use. I wonder. I've never talked to Cephas after this dungeon. Huh. It seems Cephas knows something that we don't, guys. I've been looking for you, Alundra. I have news. Bad news, of course. What are the kinders there around here? Giles is the latest victim of the nightmares. Though he was not a friend of yours, you should try to help him anyway. It would be a shame if you were to return to Magiscar prematurely, especially since you can help. I never told you of Magiscar? Oh, I must be getting senile. According to legend, everything is created and destroyed there. It is both the Alpha and Omega. We come from Magiscar when we are born, and we go there when we die. Where is it? Oh, it's north of the village near Tula Mountain. The place is crawling with slimes. You should be so lucky never to have to go there, you know what I'm saying? But guess what, guys? We do have to go there right after we talk to Giles. Or save Giles, if we can save him. Didn't you learn anything from Kline's death? Entering Giles' nightmare would be madness. You'll kill him, and probably yourself as well. Don't let that foul trickster fool you into entering his world again, Alundra. So, is that... Rumi mentioned that the villagers are at Magiscar, praying for Giles' return. Let's go over there and see that. I will meet you there. Alrighty guys, welcome to Magiscar, where the souls of apparently everybody come from when they are born and go when where they die. Looks like a little altar here. Do they even know what's inside there? Oh, Sierra! Oh my gosh, Sierra! I'm sorry, y'all. But that's probably the funniest thing I've ever seen. I'm sorry. It really is. Alright, let's go tackle Giles' nightmare. We can't get that yet. But we can in a couple episodes, though. My estimate would be about 4 to 5 more episodes. Maybe 6. Okay. Real talk, it might be more around the line of 10. Because Giles' nightmare is pretty long. So is Magiscar. Then we have to break into the sanctuary. Go through Mia's dream to find out what she's about. And then we get the spring bean, which allows us to get the fire rod. So yeah, it's probably going to be about 10 episodes before we get over there. But I'm thirsty, y'all. I need some water. I'll be right back, and I'm going to shift over myself. So it seems that the most fervent prayer person has succumbed to the darkness. Nah. Never said no! Ah! I just got berated by Keisha! Oh my gosh, I've never said no before in my life! In any of these playthroughs, I've never said no! How dare you make me plead for Giles' life! Oh my gosh! You're supposed to be a hero, now act like one! If he dies while I'm in there. Not to worry, he won't die. Neither will I, because I never die. And actually, y'all, I am starting to get the hang of these controls on this PS3 controller, which, spoiler alert, is not Sony licensed. So, come in here. We're stocked up on herbs. And this room, straight off the bat. As you can see, the nightmares are getting a little bit more deadly as opposed to what we faced with Wendell. These things, I believe they're called bug bags, basically just miniature versions of, oh, what's his name? Oogie Boogie. They're basically miniature versions of Oogie Boogie. They suck. I hate them. And one of those shadow creatures got me. Oh, here he goes. Come on. Ah, there you are. And last but not least, what, you thought that was going to be an actual treasure chest? With a key? Think again. And a switch. And now let's get out of this torture chamber. But yeah, as you can see, the nightmares are starting to get quite a bit deadlier. Like, these nightmares are actually trying to kill at this point. Wendell's dream was more just a puzzle we had to solve. Like, this nightmare is an actual death trap. Ha ha! Alrighty. Flip the switch. And now we come over here. Avoid these shadow creatures. I hate them. Don't fall down the hole. If you do, you die. Not cool. Beep, All right, people, let's try this again. I wonder if we push this way, what happens? Okay. Y'all, hold on. Alrighty, guys, I made it across and to this door, which leads us to our save and restoration point. Heal my health. Heal my magic. And let's step out of here, just in case we make a mistake and have to start this whole thing over again. I'm not sure I mentioned what episode this was. I think this is 18. Pretty sure it's 18. I wonder, is this the one? I think it's the one. Nope. It's not the one. Tis not the one. Tis this one. Those chests only contain herbs. Oh, you have to flip both switches. I see. I see now. Both switches activate the gates. Interesting. I never knew that in all the time I've been playing. Interesting. Very interesting, Sean. Or maybe it was just that switch all along. I'll have to try that next playthrough. Alrighty. I'm abusing the crap. Okay. Bad puzzle. Oh, not bad puzzle. Good puzzle. Bad puzzle coming up soon. Because you have to guess which lights to activate. And unlike Lars's crypt, it doesn't give you clues as to what to do next. So it's not as hand-holdy as Lars's crypt. Because that actually gave you clues as to how to solve the puzzles. Okay, guys, got a chest over here, two funny-looking rocks here, broken warp pad there, some spike balls here, and a doohickey here. So, here's what you don't want to do. Is step in front of these rocks, because as you can see, it closes the doors on us. Watch this on this one. It's just that door. So you have to walk behind these things, because they actually have faces. Whoa, okay. I forgot about that part. Whew, okay. Ah, this puzzle. Alrighty, I think it's this one. Then this one. Then this one. And then this one. You have to hit them in that particular order. Now! Really? Really? Like, are you kidding me right now? Because watch. See? Doesn't activate. Okay. So yeah, you have to smack them in this order. Always. Forever and ever without fail. And run through. Yeah! Come on! This is why I prefer my DualShock controller, guys. Alrighty. Just jump to the left. And get our Gilded Falcon. Diagonal jump across. Grab this block of ice. Ignore my phone going off in the background! Oh, come on! Oh. Okay. Alrighty. I'll be right back, y'all. Alrighty. We have our ice block back. Oh, come on! Alright, guys, we're back. We made it across. We have our ice block. And now we just throw it on the pedestal. Couple slimes, no big deal. Kill these guys, and we get another ice block to throw on that pedestal. Which, if I'm not mistaken... Okay. Shadow creatures. Honestly, guys, I think those look kind of like a miniature version of Melzus, if you really look at them. Hold up, and come in here. Because... apparently this activates something. Come on. There we go. Alright. I think that activates something, but I'm not sure what. But I think I missed my opportunity to go get into that bombable wall area. But what I really want, though, is in here. Go through the maze, get to the end, and you are rewarded if you are fast enough, which I probably will not be with... Oh, I was fast enough, yes! A life vessel, number 24. But if you were not fast enough, then, yeah, that chest gets... sent up into the air. And I apparently just barely missed it. So, good for me. This room is... okay. I honestly think that bomb wall only contained, like, a, a Wonder Essence and a Strength Elixir. I'm gonna try this combo, see if it works. Oh, hey. Boom. Honestly, guys, I don't even know how I did that. I just winged it. I really did. That could have taken me hours. Honestly. Bug bags. Alrighty, this puzzle might take me a little bit, so I might have to pause this, but you have to activate 3 switches, and I actually am probably going to get it up. Oh my god, I got it on my first try. Holy, okay, but, okay, So, what you want to do is jump down this hole right here and land on this rock. And as you can see, we get stopped by some bug bags who want our rock. Honestly, aha, so that does work. Aha. Alrighty. Don't get hit, otherwise this block will break. Throw it on here, and we are down, 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 through a burning ring of... Oh, shoot, guys, we are a little bit over time here, we actually got a little bit more accomplished than what I expected, so, if you liked this video, be sure to, let me know by smashing that like button, and, as always, let me know what you thought about this video by leaving a comment down below. And, as usual, our mission for this video is accomplished because we are right outside the boss room door. Two more doors and we will be at the boss, which will be a very familiar face for all of you. So, this is Commander Culper signing off. I hope y'all have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time when duty calls us again.